Namaste and welcome, dear audience. It's me, Rohan Shrestha, your regular host. Welcome to the program, Atithi Devo Bhava, guest in town, Atithi Devo Bhava. Today we are going to discuss on the field of makeup. For this we have Rihat Barar, and she's the makeup artist from India, and she has worked with lots of Bollywood celebrities. Let me welcome her. Welcome, ma'am. Welcome to Nepal. Welcome to Himalaya Television.
Thanks.
Is this the first visit of yours in Nepal?
It's my second visit, and I hope that there'll be many more. I love the place. Second visit.
Okay. When did you come last time?
Exactly a year back. Mm. Exactly the same time. For the same thing. So makeup workshop. I have a lot of friends here. Always looking forward to coming back here.
Okay. What is the basic purpose of this visit of yours? Tell me something about this visit, the workshop.
The last time that I was here, we had something similar, which was a 5 days workshop. This year, we have done the exact same thing where we have a 5 days workshop, but we also had an advanced level. Because last year, I did sort of learn that everybody was interested in pursuing this as a profession also.
In Nepal. Right.
So after the whole basic session, which was last year, this year we also introduced the advanced session at VLCEC, which was great because we got a lot of help from them. We got a lot of products which everybody could try on and practice to see how to work as a professional.
Okay. Tell us something about yourself. How long it's been that you have been working in this field career path?
I'm basically a fine artist. I've done my bachelor in fine arts. So I've always loved color. I've always loved brushes. I was never the academic type. I could never study, but I always saw art in everything. And I was naturally interested in makeup and hair since I was younger. I guess just being a girl, it just comes to us. But what really helped was that I would do makeup for my friends, and then their friends wanted to get it done for me as well. So everybody just suggested that I go professional with it, and then their fine art talent turned into painting faces instead of painting canvases.
Did you face any obstacles while choosing this as your career path? Because in our society, in the society like ours in Nepal or India, this is not considered as the best profession that one should pursue on.
True, because there is a lot of travel, there is a lot of staying out of home completely, there is all taking care of yourself. So you have to be very confident, you have to be very sure. But it is a very rewarding profession, because no matter what anybody else says, at the end of the day, when you make your bride happy, how her parents and the bride showers love on you the day she feels like a princess, it's just irreplaceable. I mean, that feeling is the best. That being said, I feel like our society is now becoming very conscious of it. So they have now understood that it is actually a profession, a very serious profession, and you need very serious skills for it. You just can't become a makeup artist. You need to be a good artist to actually make someone else look good, because most girls can dress up their own face. But to dress up someone else, you need to understand the scientific way of doing makeup behind everything.
What kind of scientific way you are talking about?
Right, so see, when I meet someone new, I have to understand what their skin type is without them even telling me. I have to understand their skin tone. So we have to carry 10 different types of products. We can't survive with just one product. So there's 10 different types of products. You have to know exactly what kind of skin type you are dealing with, how to prepare it, what products you have to use, and how to finish it. And on top of all of that, it has to match the complexion shade. And everyone has their own sort of complexion. Someone has bigger eyes, someone has smaller eyes. So for every face, it changes completely. So you have to understand the face cuts and all of those things. So it is a very complicated.
So it has to go to nitty gritty of an individual.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Let's focus on this workshop. It's not makeup, it is a face artistry. What does this mean?
So like you said yourself, I think that the society doesn't take the word makeup very seriously because it sounds very frivolous, it sounds very shallow. But like I just explained this entire thing, that it isn't just that you just go in for a makeup. It is face artistry. You have to understand how to do art on someone's face to really get the best out of the skill. Mm-hmm. And that's why we call it that.
You have worked with lots of celebrities in Bollywood. Tell us something about them. Whom did you work with? Like, you work in the bridal makeup as well. Share some experience of yours.
So celebrities, I mean, you know, when you meet them for the first time, you are a little shocked mm-hmm. because they look very different in person than they do on your screen.
How does this Bollywood divide? You have some names, Sonam Kapoor, Madhuri Dixit, similarly Nargis, Kajol, my personal favorite, and Parineeti Chopra. How does they look and how do they behave? Because most of the time, they in the set as well, they spend time with the makeup artist.
Yes, maximum
how
time.
How is their personal characteristics? Can you please highlight some?
You know, what is very important is that since they are sharing their closest space with us, we have to be absolutely professional about it. Mm-hmm. We have to make sure that anything that is discussed in the room does not go out. So even they extend that sort of courtesy towards you. They are very respectful for everybody they work with because a star wouldn't be a star without their entire team. And everybody, like their stylist, like their photographer, like their dietitian, the same way the makeup artist is a part of their team. So well, the behavior with us is fantastic, but everybody has their own sort of personality. Mm-hmm. But more than anything else, you sort of learn that it isn't an easy line at all. If they are required to be at set by 5 a.m., they will be there. They will not be delaying things because the people they are working with, directors, photographers, even they are equally big. And it is the entire team, like I said, that makes the star big. So it's a lot of hard work. It is a lot of gymming. It's a lot of giving up on like amazing food. Mm-hmm. It is living a proper, very strict lifestyle. So we just see the whole glamour bit of it. But when you meet them, you just realize that it is the toughest line because you just work so hard. You have to be very disciplined for it.
Okay.
And you kind of learn discipline from them. And they will always be very professional.
But it is said that they are not punctual enough.
See, everybody has their own 30 minutes on, off. And we're mostly shooting in a metro city where traffic conditions are bad. And there are times that a lot of big artists have from 5 to about 10 shoots a day. So, you know, even they can only do so much. So I would understand that. But since I have mostly worked with just women, they are mostly in time because they understand the things like makeup and dressing up take a lot more time mm-hmm. on them. So the actors, some of them, even I've just heard, I haven't seen any actor getting late, but none of the women are later than say more than 30 minutes.
That's what about Madhuri Dixit and Kajol, the black beauty of Bollywood cinema?
Right.
How are they?
So again, I was assisting my boss when she was working on them. So the thing is that when you meet them, I always thought that since they have so much experience, they have so much exposure, they will be very full of themselves or simply mm-hmm. that they won't be warm. But they were very warm. And I completely understand if they get harassed, if people are perpetually trying to take pictures or all of those things. See, because they have been in this line for so long that post a certain point, it can get a bit mm-hmm. annoying. But again, with us, they were so much fun. Like Kajol was so much fun. She's mm-hmm. so full of life.
She has got the bubbly kind of image.
Absolutely, mm-hmm. absolutely. So she is that bubbly, happy person, even off screen, okay. you know, very, very, very warm, very humble.
What about male artists? Have you worked with?
So I've worked with most male models
okay.
Because I've done a lot of fashion shoots again. So again, I haven't worked with any of the big male artists, but again, I've met them in first quarters because I was at the IFA 2015. So we very closely worked with Hrithik Roshan, Nils Farhan Akhtar and all of these guys. They're so full of life again. I think we don't give our male actors enough credit because they are so witty, they will be keeping the set alive, you know. So they are what keep the entire team going.
What about the comfort zone? Since you are female and you are doing the makeup of the male artist, male model, how do you feel? Because this is the South Asian society, we all know that.
Right. So what happens is that, again, when you're in the middle of a shoot, number one, you are given very little time. Even if you have to change someone's hair or makeup, you will be barely given 15 minutes because light is of key essence when you're at a location shoot especially. So say if we are shooting at one of these forts, so you get 15 minutes, and in that 15 minutes, you don't even get to talk to the person much. It is just dab, 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 and run out. You know, so everyone is so professional and everyone is so focused on performing their best, because all of these opportunities are very big opportunities given to any individual in that place. So all of us are so professional, all of us are in such a rush that you just get to be familiar with the person's name and that's about it, you know. But yeah, so it is a very comfortable zone for everybody involved.
Can you please share something on the overall status of this makeup artist field in Bollywood, or let's say in the South Asian countries like India or Nepal? What is their condition?
See, India makeup artists are very big. In the last 2 years, I've seen a sudden boom in the freelance makeup artists, whether they are bridal, whether they are editorial.
Because again, the things come that people, they want to look good, but they won't give much priority or let's say respect to the makeup artist. How do you feel?
You know, I feel like the generation before us would still think like that a little bit, but our generation, my generation, is so respectful because they want all of this. They understand that it is a complicated art. Even when I am using all of my products, they feel so happy that I am sourcing products for them that are not easily available in Asia itself. So there is a lot of respect now after the kind of exposure that everybody has gained. So it's changed the whole game plan for makeup artists everywhere.
There are problems in every sector.
Absolutely.
What kind of problems that the makeup artist faces?
Clients. So some clients, you know, I mean, again, everyone has their own personality. And whenever it is more than one person doing a certain sort of work, it does get a bit difficult. So here, there are two of us. One is me and one is my client. So clients, once the makeup is done, they just calm down completely because then they have seen their face manifest into a completely different beautiful face. They are pretty even otherwise, but you know, like bridal day is the day that you will see yourself done up the maximum. But before that day, they will drive you completely nuts. But again, I completely understand that, but it just gets a bit much now. If I have 20 clients booked, if they ask me 20 questions a day, it's like I'm only answering their questions all day. And usually once you have met a client, you have answered all of their queries, you have taken care of all of their doubts. But I guess it is their biggest day, they will always have doubts, they will always drive you crazy till it's the day off and you're completely done. So that does get a bit difficult.
So clients, really they are big, sometimes they create a problem.
Yes, and you really have to be patient, you really have to be patient.
What about rest, if something?
Well, the mothers then, they will drive you a little crazy.
See,
because a lot of times, the girl will be from our generation, so she will want something different from what the mother wants. So the mother will
want... This is why doing the bridal makeup?
Yes. So that's why I don't let any mothers into the room while I'm dressing up the bride, because it's very important that the bride gets what she wants. You can't make all 100 guests happy. You should just be happy with what you want. So that gets a little difficult. You can't make everybody happy ever.
You guys are the man behind the man maker, king maker, let's say, celebrity maker. But sometimes don't you feel that people, they only talk about the celebrities, not about you people, not about the guys behind it?
True, very true. But again, I feel like we are beginning to now get our due credit, and I must thank all sort of social media platforms for it, because again, now that everyone is getting very conscious, they will want to know who's doing Sonia Kapoor's makeup. They will want to know exactly how her makeup is being done, and they will follow all of her styles. If she will do a wing liner with red lips, everybody will want to do the same thing. So again, that respect for the artist behind the show is now beginning to really come in, and social media is fantastic because now we get tagged in every post. Everybody wants to follow you to also know what sort of a life you are living. And even they want to know what is it like to be around a celebrity.
Okay. Even the general public, they want to know something behind the camera as well.
Absolutely.
Okay. What is the beauty for you?
Oh, for me, if the person as a personality isn't pretty, no amount of prettiness on the face will make them a pleasing personality. So for me, you have to be beautiful inside out. You cannot. So a lot of times, even when the makeup is looking fantastic, but if your client is just a grumpy person, they will not look pretty, you know, because they will be frowning, they will be grumpy till the photographer is like, can you please smile?
They are not happy from inside.
Exactly. So when you're happy inside, that is when your beauty really shows through. You're a better person and you're making everybody around you happy. So I think that is more beautiful.
There is a demarcation, beauty and ugly. Is there such or not?
Not really. See, for me, again, it is about the personality. You can have an ugly personality, you can't have an ugly face. Especially for a makeup artist, ugly doesn't exist, because we are there to change and to make even the prettiest face a bit better, you know. So for us, ugly doesn't exist.
So there is no such demarcation like ugly and the beauty.
Nothing. We are always trying to beautify everybody, trying to take it up a notch always.
There is a thought in the society like one should look beautiful, one should look attractive to get success in different fields. Do you believe it or not?
Sadly enough, I absolutely believe in it.
So one should look beautiful, one should look
absolutely
attractive.
But also I feel that it depends on your line of work. Now, if you are in the line of, say, PR, you're talking to new people every day. They have to feel comfortable. You have to have that sort of pleasing personality. So for that, it does help if you look good, because people automatically like people who look good or who sort of present themselves well.
Don't you think that this will create a kind of, you know, sense of humiliation among those who are not so beautiful or
not
so
really
attractive?
I mean, I am always more attracted to anybody who has more to talk about life, or just about general knowledge, or just about life experiences. You see, you can't talk to a pretty face for very long if they don't have the brains for it. But if someone has the sort of life experience that can keep you interested, that is what keeps it going. So I don't think it is a pretty face that will sort of keep your attention, you know. But a good brain, a very well-informed person, a pleasing personality is what can keep a conversation going and can keep you interested.
Okay. Beauty and makeup, it always is associated with the financial status of an individual.
Right.
Do you believe it or not?
That is completely changed. Everybody is not just beauty conscious, but also fashion conscious. So everybody is now in their own means figuring out ways of looking pretty and absolutely fashionable.
How can general public carry themselves, the housewife, the office goers, because they don't have that enough asset to invest in the beauty products, the branded beauty products.
Yes.
How
yes.
can they carry themselves? Let's begin from the individual, because in this workshop as well, there is, you know, self-grooming basic makeup master classes.
See, that's why makeup classes, especially in today's times, are very important, because we can make someone's regime from, say, a very elaborate 30 product requirement down to a 5 product requirement. And trust me, everybody has the budget for minimal 5 products, and we make it a very quick thing for them. So we will help all of our clients figure out a very quick everyday routine to a little heavier, say, lunch or like dinner routine, to a heavier wedding or say a nighttime
routine. How can housewife look pretty?
Right. All that she has to do is take time, literally just 10 minutes for herself before she sleeps. She just needs to do skincare even more than makeup for herself, because I have seen that women completely ignore themselves once they're married because they have to take care of so many others. So if you just take out the 10 minutes, moisturize your skin very well. Moisturizing is the biggest anti-aging thing in the world. It'll keep your skin supple, you will look fresh, you will look pretty, you will feel good. So moisturize yourself head to toe those 10 minutes before you sleep. That is basic, you know. So that's what the housewives need to start with.
What about male and female office goers?
Male and female office goers, I feel like for men, basic grooming, like just scrubbing your skin well and gelling your hair, can do a big, like, it can just make a huge difference. Whereas for women, it is very basic things in terms of say makeup specifically. Women just need to, again, have clean skin. They need to have very clean skin. They just need to put a lot of mascara. I'm a big believer of mascara. It just makes your eyes look fresh. And I feel like your face will never look fresh till your eyes look bright and fresh and you look awake. So just keep a mascara.
Making a fresh face. Don't you think that the chemicals used in this products like mascara, you have just said that, and beside that the gel, don't you think that it creates, it hampers the skin and the hair?
It absolutely does, you know, but now there are so many brands all over the world. So you literally have 10,000 options to pick from according to your skin type, according to your consciousness level. So there are a lot of products in the market that are now chemical-free, paraben-free. So you can take your pick now because everyone is so beauty conscious. There is a product for everybody.
Is it necessary to use branded or hi-fi products? Expensive one?
Right. So I always say that the only difference between the cheaper products and hi-fi products is that the hi-fi products, if it says that this thing will stay for 12 hours, it will actually deliver that. So that is the only thing, because all of these bigger brands have to live up to their name. They can't afford any bad name for themselves, so they will deliver whatever they promise, whereas local brands, everything just comes off sooner than you would expect. That is the only difference.
Do you want to say something about VLCC itself?
Well, I feel like this workshop at VLCC this particular year was a lot of help to me, simply because, like I said, we were doing a professional course. So it was very important for me, the way VLCC helped us with their tools, with the sort of exposure it gave to the clients. And personally enough, I love the whole spa here, because when I flew in, I was exhausted, I wasn't feeling well. So a body spa here completely rejuvenated me. So this association worked very well, both professionally and personally with them.
At last, if you have got to say something to our audience, then you are free to.
Well, nothing, just that feel pretty inside. And there are always makeup artists like me who will have these classes. If not me, there are others. Please take up makeup classes so you know exactly what to pick and you don't waste extra money. You will waste your money on the right things instead of just blowing it up on things that are not good.
Well, thank you so much for your time.
Anytime.
And wonderful, beautiful opinions.
Thank you. It was such a pleasure.
The audience, thanks to you as well for your time. Please do stay with us for more news and entertainment packages. Keep watching Himalaya Television. Namaste.